Hello friends, welcome to today's video. So today we will be discussing the chapter 19, which is the airlines in India. This is a part of the syllabus of airport operations AAI, and in general it is also a part of the current affairs of aviation, which is useful for ATC. Starting with the first airline, the Indigo. You know, Indigo is also known as Interglobe Aviation Limited. So the headquarters of Indigo Airlines is located in the Gurgaon, Haryana. This you can remember. It is the largest airline in India. This is the key term. Largest airline in India is the Indigo with respect to the domestic passengers. Okay. It occupies a market share of 59.24% of domestic in India. As of today also, it is the largest. Okay. Next, who is the CEO? Is Mr. Ronoja is the CEO of the Indigo Airlines. So the total aircraft which Indigo is having more than 250. You know, not many airlines have 250 plus aircraft. Indigo is one such airline in India which is having 250 plus aircraft, and also it is the first airline to have 250 plus aircrafts in India. You know, in airline, if you have traveled in the flight, you will know a magazine will be given to the passengers of the airline. The Indigo Airlines have a magazine which is known as Hello 6E. This you can remember. It is an in-flight magazine available for the passengers to read. The key points from this Indigo is located in Haryana, largest airline in India. It has more than 250 aircrafts, and the magazine is Hello 6E. Next is the SpiceJet. SpiceJet Airlines is also headquarters in Gurgaon, it is in India. So it is the second largest airline in the country by the number of domestic passengers carried. This you can remember, SpiceJet is the second largest airline. The market share is 13.6% of the domestic passengers. The CEO and the MD is the Mr. Ajay Singh. He is the MD. There is one more division of SpiceJet, which is operating as a cargo, which is the Spice Express. This you can remember. Spice Express is the cargo division of the SpiceJet. And also recently you know that SpiceJet has also launched the seaplane services, which is known as a Spice Shuttle. This is also a key term to remember. Spice Shuttle is a subsidiary of SpiceJet, which operates the seaplanes. SpiceJet was the airline which have started the recent seaplane airline near the Statue of Unity in Gujarat. So these are the key terms: second largest airline and Spice Express and Spice Shuttle. Moving to the next important airline, which is the Vistara Airlines. Vistara Airlines is owned by a Tata Group. You know, it is Tata SIA Airlines Limited. It is operating as Vistara Airline. The headquarters is again in Gurgaon only. The CEO is Mr. Leslie Tang, and which is founded in 2003. It is a joint venture. This airline is a joint venture. Tata Sons and the Singapore Airlines. This is the key term to remember. And then it is the first airline to introduce a premium economy class in the domestic market. You know, normally the domestic flights will have only the economy class. They don't have a premium economy. So Vistara was the first airline to start this. This you can remember. Next is the most important airline in India, which is operated by Government of India on its behalf, is the Air India. You know, Air India history goes back to 1932. It was started by JRD Tata as the Tata Airlines. Then later it was renamed to Air India, you know, recently. So Air India is a flag carrier airline of India. This is important to remember. This is a flag carrier airline headquartered in New Delhi. So it is owned by the Air India Limited, a government owned enterprise. So you know, this is the Air India is the largest international carrier out of India. So largest international carrier. Whereas Indigo was the domestic carrier, largest domestic carrier, whereas Air India is the largest international carrier. You might have seen the one Maharaja is the mascot of the Air India, you know. The logo consists of a flying swan with a wheel of Konark in it. You can just remember the name Maharaja, you know. This is the mascot of Air India. You might have remembered this. Next, You know, the in-flight magazine of the Air India is known as the Shubh Yatra, which means happy journey. So it's a bilingual in-flight magazine published both in English and Hindi. This you can remember, Shubh Yatra. So by the domestic capacity, if you see, Air India is the third largest in India with respect to the domestic market. Whereas for international, it is the first. So these are the key terms with respect to the Air India airline. Next is another airline, which is the Go Air. Go Air is based in Mumbai, Maharashtra. You know, remaining all are in normally found in New Delhi or Gurgaon, but then Go Air is in Maharashtra group. It is owned by the Wadia group. There is nothing much about Go Air, you know. The CEO is Mr. Kaushik Khona. Next is Air Asia India. Air Asia India is headquartered in Bengaluru, Karnataka. So it is also a joint venture, just like the Vistara. So it's a joint venture, Tata Sons and the Air Asia Investment Limited, which is holding 16.66 stake. So Tata Sons are the owner of this airline. This you have to remember. This is a very important. It may be asked in the exam because it happened recently only that the stake got increased to 83.67%. So now it is owned by Tata Group. Air Asia India. Next is we'll move ahead to know smaller airlines. One Air Deccan is a regional Indian airline which is currently operating only from Ahmedabad, Gujarat. It was operated under the RCS scheme. It has only 219 aircraft. There is not much, but you can remember that this airline is based from Gujarat. You know. Next is another emerging airline is Star Air. So the headquarters is in Bengaluru, Karnataka. This also you can remember, like Air Asia Limited. Star Air is also based in Bengaluru, Karnataka. It is a venture of the Sanjay Gudavat Group. This you can remember. It is one of the emerging airlines, and it has only Embraer 145LR aircraft in its fleet. This you can remember. So TrueJet is an Indian regional airline based at Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad. Next is Blue Dart Aviation. I included this one because it's the only cargo airline. You know, Blue Dart is a famous courier organization. It is in the logistics department. So they have a separate base in Chennai. It is headquartered in Chennai, Tamil Nadu. This you can remember, and it is owned by the German courier company named Deutsche Post, which owns 70% of stake in the Blue Dart Express. It was a PSU under the Government of India. It is a flagship helicopter service provider. Some of the important terms to remember are like heli pilgrims. They are using the helicopter services like in the region of Uttaranchal, Uttarakhand, or Srinagar, where hilly regions are there. So there they are using these helicopter services. And the CMD is Mr. Sanjeev Razdan. This you can remember. It's a Miniratna PSU. You know, Government of India is planning to privatize this Pawan Hans also. It was incorporated on 15th October 1985 as HCI. It is also a government-owned enterprise which takes in government with ONGC. So ONGC also has some stakes in this Pawan Hans. This you can remember. Next is, till now we are discussing the normal airlines. So those are scheduled airlines. Scheduled airlines are the one which have the schedule fixed, or means they have, means before the travel they have their schedule released. So those are known as scheduled airlines. So which we have discussed above, Air India, Air India Express, Air Asia, Go Air, IndiGo, SpiceJet, and all these are scheduled airlines. Whereas regional airlines are the one which are operating under the RCS scheme, which are connecting the smaller towns. Some of the regional airlines are Alliance Air, Air Deccan, Air Heritage, Star Air, TrueJet. Next is the international airlines in India. Till now we are discussing about the national airlines. Now we'll be discussing about the international airlines. Some of the international primary airlines are Emirates, Qatar Airways, Lufthansa, Air Arabia, Etihad Airways, Thai AirAsia, Air France Airways, British Airways, Singapore Airlines, Malaysia Airlines, and Cathay Pacific. You can just remember the name, so if they ask in exam, you can just answer them. You need not remember, just go through them once or twice. You will remember these are the names of the foreign airlines. Next is the cargo airlines. Cargo airlines are the one which carries the cargo, the freight. So some of the important cargo airlines in India are the Air India Cargo, Blue Dart Aviation, Deccan 360, Spice Express, Quickjet Airlines and VRL Group. This you can remember. Next is the charter airlines. Charter airlines are privately owned, or some of the business owners, they have the chartered aircrafts. So some of these are offering the charter services which are registered. So you can remember some of the names like Pawan Hans, Taj Air, VRL. So these are the charter airlines. You can just go through them once or twice so that you will remember the names. So these are the airlines in India. You know, if you have any questions or any doubts, you can comment in the video. I'll be happy to answer them. If you have liked the video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos. Thank you for watching.